this Everton Park Sports Centre tonight is an absolute heaving bear pit. It's supposed to be holding 1,400 or so, each paying £20, but I would wager, Jim, there's a lot of people in here who haven't paid a penny, standing room only. It's like one of those throwback fights from a century ago, isn't it?
Yeah, well, you can see why. I mean, you saw how good the first fight was, and now the British title's at stake, the same two young kids. If they gave so much of themselves last time out for an area title, what will they be prepared to give for that Lonsdale belt?
This is Jamie McKeever, who won the first fight in very controversial circumstances. 7 years younger than his Merseyside rival. He's from Birkenhead and does his morning training runs through Birkenhead town centre. A real aggressor, a buzzsaw of a fighter who's never ever in a bad fight. Here's Mulholland on his way.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the ring from Liverpool, Tony Mulholland.
Well, just look at this reception that Mulholland is going to get here. He feels he was robbed in the first meeting between the two. I must say, at ringside, we tended to agree with that. That was for the central area title. Mulholland, if he does feel cheated, didn't ought to feel that way anymore, because he gets his other chance for the British title itself.
Yeah, I'm sure this is more of a bonus than anything else. But he may feel that he had worked out the tactics to beat McKeever last time out, but maybe didn't have the stamina to sustain those tactics into the later stages. He seemed to lose his way in the second half of the fight, so I'm sure he will have addressed that problem this time, and I'm sure he'll be in the very best of shape. But he was definitely outboxing McKeever in the early stages, so he has to find a way to keep that going for 12 rounds.
Yeah, the longer distance could be in McKeever's favour, possibly. Whether Mulholland can keep it going, keep his eyes out of trouble with those suspect eyes, where the scar tissue must still be a bit of it around. It's a problem for him, that, isn't it?
Yeah, and normally after a grueling war, you think the 23-year-old should be able to recover quicker than the 30-year-old. But the thing we have here is McKeever has had so many wars, much more wars than Mulholland has, so we do not know until the bell rings who is going to be the fresher here tonight.
Well, you couldn't get a better atmosphere for boxing's answer to the Merseyside derby. There's a real electricity about the place here. Richie Davis is the man with the job of keeping this under control. I reckon there are probably 2,000 people in here, not 1,400, the officially announced capacity. Mulholland is 7 years older. You heard about the weight problems McKeever had. It took an hour to get off the last 2 ounces. Is he too tight at the weight? Easier for Mulholland, reach the same. Mulholland, though, more the stylist. He was an ex-ABA champion who's been a professional for longer, but a very, very slow-burning career for him. McKeever, I would suggest, probably, despite those stats, does have an edge in experience, because he's been in some harder fights along the way. And that's what it's all about. The coveted Lonsdale bout, they've been contesting this since 1909.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome to Everton Park Leisure Centre here in the Premiership City of Liverpool. Barry Hearn for Ringside Boxing Promotions in association with Prince Promotions and Matchroom Sport. Proudly present the main event, the fight of the night, 12 rounds of boxing for the vacant British featherweight championship. Sponsored here by Hustle Roader, and a very warm welcome to our viewers joining us live and exclusive here on Sky Sports. You've joined us for the very best ringside seat in the business. All the officials have been appointed by the British Boxing Border Control here present with us at ringside. Our steward in charge, Mr. Dennis Lockton and Mr. Richard Jones. Our inspectors, Alan Alster, Mike Barnett and Bert Smith. And our three medical officers, Dr. Stead, Dr. Sim and Dr. Thomas. Timekeeper at the bell is Mr. Paul Webster. And when the action begins, the man in charge, our referee from Kent, Mr. Richie Davis. They are the officials. And now the contestants. Ladies and gentlemen, for one more time, here we go. Introducing to you, firstly, fighting out of the red corner. He's wearing the blue and white trunks and weighed in. At 8 stone, 13 1/4 pounds, and a 19 fight record. He has 17 wins, 2 inside the scheduled distance, 1 loss, 1 draw. He comes to the ring as the former ABA champion, ladies and gentlemen, from Liverpool. And now across the ring, fighting out of the blue corner. He's wearing the black and white trunks and weighed in at 8 stone, 13 pounds, 12 ounces. He has an 18 fight record, 14 wins, 4 inside the scheduled distance, 3 losses and 1 draw. He is from Birkenhead. Would you please welcome Lindler, Jamie McKeever. So, sports fans and Sky Sports fans, it's standing room only. Let's get the action underway. 12 rounds of boxing for the Vacant British Featherweight Championship.
Come on, son. Okay, fellas, now you've both had your instructions in the dress rooms. Do as you're told, behave yourself, good luck to you both. Shake hands.
The 119-year-old British Featherweight Championship held in the past by Terry Spinks, Howard Winston, Pat Cowdell, Barry McGuigan, Paul Hodkinson of Liverpool, Colin McMillan, Duke McKenzie, Paul Ingall, and most recently Scott Harrison, who's vacated this title to be contested by these two Scousers tonight. Liverpool against Birkenhead. The blue trunks of Tony Mulholland, the black of Jamie McKeever, the official winner of the first contest between these two. The brawling aggression of McKeever, the boxing skills behind the jab of Mulholland. The last time they fought, 35 stitches were needed between them, the two fighters. A lot of blood around. It was like a Sam Peckinpah movie by the end. What do you think, Jim?
Well, I think we're in for another corker, but I think when you know you're heading for a real tough fight, it's nice to think you can maybe nick a couple of the early rounds without exerting yourself too much, and I think that's what Mulholland will be thinking about here. He is the slightly better boxer of the two, so he should be looking to get 2 or 3 rounds into the bank before the war erupts.
Good left hook there from McKeever, who promised me when I spoke to him this week he'd be much more aggressive much earlier this time around. Mulholland's tactics, I think, will be to keep on the move, make McKeever miss, use his jab, use his skills, and keep those suspect eyes out of trouble for as long as he can. Has he had long enough, 5 months, for the very, very bad gashes to heal? Another left hook from a fired-up McKeever.
Mulholland's head just a little bit stationary in the first round here, a little bit more movement's going to be needed.
Keever with the right hand. Mulholland dominated the early rounds the last time they fought, behind his jab and giving it plenty of movement, and he worked nicely there with the combination. This has had a big, big build-up in the local media. Not quite as big as the fight between Holligan and Neary in these past a few years back in that tent. There's a big right hand going in early from McKeever, who's having the better of this opening round. And keeping a very close look on those eyes of Mulholland.
Mulholland's defences are letting him down here. He's not concentrating, his head's too still, he's dropping his hands. He's the one expecting the good start, this will be upsetting him.
easily the biggest night in the lives of these two fighters by a long way, with the British title itself at 9 stone on the line. Just worry about McKeever's problems in making the weight for this. In the past, he's been up as high as welterweight in his amateur days. And he struggled to get down to 9 stone at the weigh-in.
What worries me is the fact that it was only 2 ounces, but it took him so long to shed those 2 ounces, so he must have been down to skin and bone.
That's a bit better from Mulholland. Just looked a bit stiff and stationary early on, Mulholland, and McKeever had the better of that opening session. Tony Carroll and John Carroll working the corner for Jamie McKeever, whose dad, by the way, John, was on the books of West Ham United and made his son jog from the age of 5.
So he's been in shape all his life. Is it not? Well, it's paid off in the first round, but he was first to settle, he was first to get off the mark. At long range, you would not be expecting to outbox Mulholland in the first round at long range, but that's pretty much what was happening, and certainly in the early part. The long swinging punches were landing. Mulholland's defences definitely let him down. As you said, he was too stiff, his head was too stationary. He has to get his act together.
Mulholland being watched by his two little boys at ringside tonight, Anthony and Bradley, 5 years old and 2 years old. Every parent's idea, but Mulholland says he wants them here, it makes him feel better. Blue trunks, remember, the shaven skull. Mulholland, the former English ABA champion in 1996, needs to get that jab working, doesn't he, Jim?
Yeah, he's timing, he's not really got his act together. As soon as he's got to, you know, he's got to get off a lot sharper. The ideas is right, we're just taking too long to get the punches off.
One trick for Mulholland might be to see if he can get McKeever onto the back foot. Would he be as effective then? This is a real come-forward merchant, with relentless written on the waistband of his trunks, just to remind us. Sharper from Mulholland, the boxing there. Didn't get out of the way. Reflex is just not quick enough.
Yep, again, his head is far too still. He's stepping back from the punches, but he's not moving his head. He's not getting his hands up to block the shots. Lost his way, now he's been having to clinch. Really, he hasn't got his act together yet, Mulholland.
Mulholland, whose career was almost in cold storage until recent months, he's stepped up a level and now he's in for the big one domestically. Good uppercut on the inside from McKeever, who looks the looser and more confident of the two early.
Yeah, and the fact that Mulholland would be expecting to win the early rounds as he did last time, he knows he has a job on his hands, he has to come up with something so much better.
Mulholland's only stopped 2 opponents. He's not a big puncher, but he does predict that he's going to win this inside 7-8 rounds. Bit of blood from the nose, nothing much for Mulholland.
I think McKeever looks so much bigger at the moment. He's really in the driving seat.
He's actually getting his own jab working a bit, and I know he's been trying to improve his own defence as well. I think he knows he can't carry on being in these wars, thrilling though they are. And there's blood around now, the face of Mulholland as he's hit with a right hand. I don't think his eyes have burst open yet. There is 5-year-old Anthony Mulholland watching his dad in action tonight. and he wants to be here, and his dad wants him here as well. Two-year-old Bradley's there somewhere alongside him. They haven't brought along little Macy May, their sister, tonight. She's only one.
Well, you can see McKeever still having the better of things at long range.
Round three, the Vacant British Featherweight Championship. McKeever, a much faster start from him this time around.
I mean, it's faster, but it's more controlled as well. He's not having to go looking for Mulholland. He can actually control the pace and do it in a sensible manner. Excellent first two rounds from McKeever.
He gets over the right hand again. Mulholland is trying to get his boxing going, landing punches and then getting away, but as Jim's been saying, his head movement hasn't been the best yet. Just taps away at his right eye. I wonder if there's a problem just starting to develop. It does look sore around that eye. I can't see blood yet, but it does look like an accident waiting to happen.
Well, at the moment, it seems that McKeever is the one who's learned from the first meeting, because he's changed tactics. He's gone about the job totally differently. Well, Holland's just back with the same plan he had last time. It's not working. I hope for his sake he has another plan.
The worrying thing for Mulholland is that McKeever is having plenty of success catching him with the hooks. That's a bit better for Mulholland. He got his head moving that time and slipped the jab.
But you have to slip and be in a position to counter as well. So I suppose one step at a time, the fact that he's slipping is an improvement. But he's not really got himself going yet.
Needs a better round, Tony Mulholland. Basically needs to be more elusive, mixing more side-to-side movement.
Well, he's trying to counter, so he's allowing McKeever to lead off, and it's not one good left hook from McKeever.
And he was there for it as well.
I think he's maybe going to have to initiate the attacks here, trying to get the punches off quicker. Counter-punching doesn't seem to be working.
And the danger is, if this doesn't work, will he then be dragged into a toe-to-toe slugout with McKeever? And there'd probably be only one winner of that. McKeever's trying to box a little more himself behind the jab, as you said, Jim. He looks a shade more controlled than we've seen him in the past. And he's been a bit of a wild thing, hasn't he, up to now in his career?
Yeah, well, I used to think if kids were having tooth-and-nail battles at 4 and 6 round level, they were short of talent when they moved up the level. I thought McKeever might be might be an exception there, because he wants to have a tear-up. He doesn't always have to. It's as if it's tonight he's thought, I don't have to have a tear-up here. I can box here, and that's what he's doing.
There's blood around that face of Mulholland. Richie Davis with the job of repping this. The man who repped the first fight, Tony Green, resigned after all the hullabaloo over his scorecard for the first fight. It was widely believed that he actually did score in a draw, and it got wrongly announced. And I think their board of control sort of answer to all the controversy is to say, great fight, let's do it again, and put the British featherweight title on the line. And I say amen to that.
Yeah, I mean, these two are lucky if they're the top half dozen featherweights in the country. But it's an opportunity. They're both grasping, and they're certainly deserving of it.
Fourth round. It's been a much, much better start from McKeever this time. And Mulholland, the impression is he needs to start doing something differently. You see, he was just forcing McKeever back a little in the first fight.
Yeah, I think that's what he has to do. Counter-punching has not been working. He's been outboxed at long range. I'm surprised at the composure that McKeever is showing. He's never been rattled. He has a plan, and so far he's sticking to it. He's still boxing well at long range.
Could be that he's becoming a slightly more rounded, mature pro.
Yeah, well, as I said earlier, he has tear-ups because he wants to have tear-ups. It's not really because he's so short of talent that he has to. He enjoys pleasing the fans, but tonight, this is a big night. The Lonsdale belt at stake, so maybe he's just taking a little tumble to himself and trying to use a bit of talent.
McKeever, who learnt to box when arguments with his brother and cousin were settled with the gloves on when they were not much more than toddlers. So boxing's in the blood, all right. McKeever's got his jab going, hasn't he? That's one of the surprises in this fight so far.
Yeah, but it's a completely different attitude from McKeever. He is the one who has learned from the first fight. I mean, already Mulholland has a mountain to climb because I don't know that he has the technique to combat what's coming his way. I mean, he has to lead off more. Counterpunch is not working, but he's still sticking with that. Maybe he doesn't have the physical strength to come forward. Then he has big problems.
Well, part of the makeup of a championship fighter is to think on his feet in there and, if necessary, switch strategies.
McKeever's winning the rounds well within himself. He's not having to bust a gut to win these rounds. Everything's under control, really boxing well, taking his shots nicely.
Now, is there blood around the left eye developing for Mulholland? If there isn't, it looks quite angry, doesn't it? What do you think, Jim? It's hard to see, isn't it?
It's just looking at bruising at the moment. I've got a little bit of blood on the bridge of the nose.
No cut.
Mulholland, he's committing himself a little bit more, but still there's not great method in what he's doing when he comes forward. He doesn't seem to be solving this style out.
Jabs landed so far. Look at that. There's the surprise stat of the night so far. Four rounds gone. Look at that.
Yeah, well, I think McKeever has decided to totally change everything. And as I say, I mean, it's a masterclass by his standards. I mean, usually he's head down and just let the punches flow. He's thinking what he's doing. Really, he is the one who's learned from the first outing. I think Mulholland was expecting to pick up where he left off, but McKeever's come with different ideas. Maybe just see the little bit of damage there. It just looks like bruising at the moment, a little bit of blood in the bridge of Mulholland's nose. But there's no real method in anything that Mulholland has done so far.
He's got to Benny King there, the good cuts man, working the corner. The main man is John Rice with John Naylor, and George Vaughan's around there, his old trainer somewhere. Fifth round. Mulholland needs to start putting some rounds in the bank here. I just got the impression, talking to him this week, Tony Mulholland, that he was quite concerned about keeping his eyes out of harm's way. And I wonder if that is in some way inhibiting his performance.
I wonder, but of the two, when they came into the ring, he was the one who really seemed fired up. You know, you could see him making fists, and the grimace he had in his face, as though he was ready to declare war. And it's been quite the opposite. He's been on the back foot trying to counter-punch his way. That's not been working, but he hasn't really tried much else. Although some credit has to be given to McKeever for that, because his tactics so far have been spot on.
Different sort of fight from the first one. Not so explosive, McKeever, just picking his punches a little more. Not charging in, looking after himself in there, you feel. There's a good right uppercut from him there as well.
I mean, you would think McKeever's had half a dozen fights between their last meeting and now there's such a change in what he's doing.
Decent little right-hand counter from Mulholland, who goes into a little bit of showboating, but kind of walked onto a right hand. At the moment, Birkenhead winning the Battle of the Mersey as they build it up here.
That was a beautiful right hand. If McKeever had been a natural puncher, I think Mulholland would have found himself in the floor from that one. That was a perfectly delivered right hand.
Because the McAteer boxing family used to come from Birkenhead as well, didn't they? A generation or so ago.
Closer round here, but I still think the better punching comes from McKeever.
Oh, and another very good right, fast, and picked it well.
He's actually outboxing Mulholland, so what Mulholland's going to do about that, I don't know. He can't outfight him, he must have been expecting to outbox him, and that's not happening.
As he's just at a much, much lower level, doing something that Barrera did with Hamed, coming up with something completely different than the other guy was expecting.
That's exactly what he's done. I mean, he's a completely different boxer tonight, McKeever. I have to give him full credit.
Can Mulholland adapt and do enough about that? I mean, it's not like he's totally dominant or anything, McKeever, but he's just putting the rounds away. That's the impression you have at the moment.
Cash Converters. Welcome to Cash Converters. Do you need cash now? We can give you cash when you need it. And it's so simple. Bring any of these items into a Cash Converter store and we could give you instant cash.
We buy, we sell, we loan cash and we cash checks.
We are the Cash Converters.
Welcome back to the Everton Park Sports Centre, this local derby. McKeever has had his cut problems in the past too. He was badly cut himself in the first fight, just minor damage so far. The brawler's turned boxer.
Yeah, there's a lot of clever stuff coming from that. There's a lovely uppercut that we just saw on replay there.
Sixth round. McKeever in the black trunks, contesting the vacant British featherweight championship here. Proud old title that goes back a long, long way, back into the last century. And this is the best division in British boxing at the moment, with Harrison, McCulloch, Hamed and Brody at the top of it. Four world-class operators. I wonder what that fella Hamed's doing these days. Oh, he's coming with a body shot, and down goes Mulholland. Delayed action fall, and there's another breakthrough for McKeever. The count at seven. Mulholland, is he going to get up? Eight. He got up with the count at eight, but he looks pained. He looks pained, and he looks distressed. And I wasn't sure he was going to beat the count, and I wonder whether McKeever is going to have him here.
Well, McKeever wants to do the same thing, keep cool, keep calm, and pick his shots as he's been doing.
It's been a terrific display, this, from Jamie McKeever, who's moved to another level tonight. All his family are here watching him, his dad John, his mum Denise, and lots of other family and friends too. He's got a couple of kids of his own, by the way.
Well, he's totally in charge now, looking more confident with every round that passes.
Left jab and then the right, and Mulholland has few answers at the moment. His strategy for this fight just hasn't worked. Simple as that. And as he moves away from the left hand, he walks onto the right sometimes. He's getting cut off.
I don't remember seeing such an improvement in a young fighter from one fight to the next. I mean, this is like a totally different boxer tonight.
I think he got pretty fed up with reading and hearing from the likes of us on Sky that he really lost the fight the first time around. He was hurt a bit by that. Doesn't feel he got enough credit and wants to settle the argument once and for all here.
Well, we're giving him some credit tonight because this is faultless so far.
Mulholland is running out of ideas, and is that enough? Another body shot, and he basically backed away, and Richie Davies said enough is enough. Jamie McKeever is the British featherweight champion after a dramatically improved performance. He won it big. Mulholland was never in it this time. The brawler of old turned into a boxing stylist for the night, mixed in some heavy shots as well, and could not have done that more emphatically or conclusively. No arguments this time.
No arguments whatsoever. I think for a change, we're seeing the benefits of the British scoring system with just the referee scores, because Richie Davis knows McKeever has won every round because he's scoring it that way, I'm sure. And he knows that Mulholland, being an ex-fighter himself, he knows Mulholland really can't get himself back into this fight. So twice, he'll have been ripped apart by body shots. Time was to call it a day. There were no real complaints from Tony Mulholland. His pride will be hurt, but thankfully, physically, he's not been hurt. I think the referee picked the right time to step in there.
What a proud night for 23-year-old Jamie McKeever of Birkenhead. They'll be celebrating there, other side of the Mersey. And follows the likes of Paul Hopkinson, who went on to be a WBC champion, and indeed Nell Tarleton, the man who used to pack out Anfield 70 or 80 years ago, great stylist and local hero of,
that well, left hook to the body there, you know,
years ago.
Beauty.
Great shot, wasn't it? That was the one that put him down. And Mulholland at the end of this basically had just told the ref, I've had enough of it.
These punches were not keeping McKeever away, and bang, another shot under the elbow. You can see the pain in his face there, all over for the night. You just see it, just as he moved away, that's it.
Yeah, there was another body shot, delayed action.
Had enough, the signs were there, the referee read them well.
McKeever was too strong, and yes, too skillful tonight.
There it goes, there's the shot. Bang on the ribs, then he steps back, and that's when that little delayed action takes place. See, the punches, you can toughen up your stomach muscles, nothing you do with the rib cage, and that punch was bang on the rib cage.
And the likes of Gary Thornhill, Nicky Cook, and Roy Rutherford will be waiting in line to get a shot at this title. They probably thought they deserved it ahead of these two tonight. But McKeever, make no mistake about it, was a deserving and proud winner of the British Featherweight Championship here on Merseyside, in front of his own fans tonight.
Time keeper Paul Webster has recorded a time of 2:45 of the sixth round. Referee Richie Davis has stopped the contest. Mulholland in no position to continue. Your winner and a new British Featherweight Champion from Birkenhead, Jamie McKeever. And ladies and gentlemen, please show your appreciation for a very, very game challenger indeed, from Liverpool, Tony Mulholland. And now to present the coveted Lonsdale belt, we call upon our supervisor, Mr. Dennis Lockton.
Well, if he can keep up this rate of improvement, we'll be back to see McKeever in big fights on Merseyside. Certainly, British title defences after that display. Amazing improvement, and who knows, at 23, maybe lots more still to come. And here tonight, some great action still to come at light middleweight. Jamie Moore, one of our light middle prospects, live tonight against the Russian Ahmed Oligov. And a thriller already at lightweight here in Liverpool tonight between two of the top 10 in Britain, Gary Hibbert and Anthony Maynard. All that still to come. But no question that McKeever is a young man we're going to get to know a little bit better. Ed Robinson now is with our winner.
Well, Jamie, crowned King of the Mersey tonight. Another thrilling battle, but it seemed a lot easier than last time.
Yeah, I always knew it was going to be a tough fight. I prepared for a tough fight, but on the last performance, and I never boxed too well, but no disrespect to Tony, he boxed out of his skin. But I didn't box too well, and I knew that with the preparation I had for this fight, I never done nothing over Christmas, I've been locked away. I knew that I'd be British champion.
Tony's tactics were very different this time around. He was looking to box on the back foot a lot more.
Yeah, well, that's what we said, really. We said if he was going to force the fight, he may not last the 12, but if he's going to bow on the back foot, on the front foot, there's a lot of fighters that had trouble with me, the best in Britain, definitely. So we knew it wouldn't go the distance to say this. If I've said 5 to 6 rounds, and it happened.
And British champion now, what does it mean to you holding that Lonsdale belt?
It means the world to me. I mean, I've always set my set, me sights high, even as, you know, as an amateur, but I knew I'd be a British champion. For some reason, I haven't got a brilliant style, but I've got the heart of a lion, and it gets you through in the end, and I'm just happy to have this belt wrapped around me.
23 years of age, where do you go from here?
I'm still young. I've got a lot of improvements to do, I know that. I mean, I couldn't improve on my heart, and my strength is very, very underrated. And that's another thing that people do underrate me on, because I started off at lightweight, not many knockouts, but people who fight me see the strength of McKeever. So I think we've got to go and do a bit of improving before we, you know, step up to maybe European or Commonwealth. But defending this a few times, I'd like to keep it for real, you know.
Well done tonight, Jamie.
Thanks a lot, Ed.